The following is an illustration of a pipe system connected to a nozzle. In it, fluid flows from left to right. So, we want to calculate the properties of the fluid in the nozzle. In this series, we will use the volume control approach. So, the first stage is to create a control volume. Here are the control volume. When viewed from the side, the area where fluid flows in or out is called the control surface. So, in this control volume there are two control surfaces. At the inlet. And at outlets. At time t0, inside the control volume there is a certain amount of fluid. Of course, the volume of the fluid is the same as the volume of the control volume. Well, a fluid volume has various properties, such as mass, energy, momentum, angular momentum, and entropy. All of these properties depend on mass. So, this property is an extensive property. Extensive properties can be transformed into intensive properties by dividing the extensive property by mass. Thus, the unit becomes per unit mass. To simplify writing, let's assume the extensive property is N, and the intensive property is eta. After delta T then, the fluid volume moves towards the outlet. Some are still in the control volume. Others have left the control volume. Thus, the fluid properties inside the control volume also change. Using the concept of rate of change, derivative of ns with respect to t is equal to the limit as delta t approaches 0 of ns at time t0 plus delta t minus ns at time t0 divided by delta t. S here is a system. At time t0, the magnitude of the system properties is none other than the properties of the control volume. Ns at time t0 is the same as ncv at time t0. Cv here is short for control volume. Let's just say, there are areas 1, 2, and 3. At time t0 plus delta t, Ns at time t0 plus delta t is the property in area 2 plus the property in area 3. Well, the property in area 2 is the property of the control volume minus the property in area 1. Enter all values. Using calculus analysis, we will get dn dt in the system is equal to the partial derivative with respect to t of the integral eta rho with respect to the control volume, plus the integral with respect to the control surface of the eta rho vector v dot vector dA. This is the mathematical statement of Reynolds Transport Theorem. Hopefully it's useful. And, don't forget to watch the next video.
I feel this pain, you already know. Turn that to gains, let my money show. I've got these things that I can't let go. Watch me turn this life into something that you can never own.